And so I think, like, actually kind of take the opposite of how far can we push bringing fun, playful things into the home while obviously being, like, sustainable to the home and not just making, like, you're destroying everything. What's up, guys? Jeff and Jeremy here. Another episode of 5 Minute Fatherhood. Fun couple things. If you're watching this on YouTube, which, by the way, if you're not, we are on YouTube every single episode. We absolutely love it. It's fun. If you want to subscribe and check us out on there, sometimes we hold up things or use things, or it's just fun to watch on video. But if you are watching, you'll notice a little different set from Jeremy. I think he said we had some furnace problems in the studio, so the next 5 to 10 episodes will look like this awesome, aesthetically vibing brick wall behind Jeremy, which is kind of fun. And then also, kind of, I wouldn't call this a repeat episode, but a deviation of an episode we've done in the past that you guys liked. And this one is 5 ways to help your kids burn energy in the winter. We've done an episode talking about embracing winter as a family team, and you guys really love that. So we wanted to focus one layer down of, okay, well, what about high energy kids specifically? What about when kind of the house gets pent up? And so we're just going to rattle off 5 really quick ones. And the first one is exercise as a family. This is a big one. We like to do something like this. Jeremy, I'd love to hear how you guys do this with older kids. But for us with toddlers, it really just means, like, do anything that's active. So chase the kids around the house. That's a game we actually play where I'll actually basically kind of just, like, be them. I think they call it, like, Mad Duck or something like that, which is this game that their grandpa taught them, which basically just run around and chase each other. And that is our version of exercise when you're toddlers. Or I'll actually do this little app, like the Nike app on the iPad, which is a really fun one where I'll actually try to incorporate. We do it in the garage and incorporate the kids to, like, hey, do it with me. Do the push-ups, do the crunches, all that stuff. And that's a really fun one. And I noticed that really helps. Even though I will say, by the way, granted, you know, we do live in Maui, so we don't have that, like, struggle as much with winter. It's just more just struggle with toddlerhood, which is its own winter. Winter is coming. Toddlers have came. But yeah, Jeremy, what would you say?
Yeah, another one, you guys, is that there are all these new kind of video game platforms that require movement. You know, like, they use balls. They kind of use that kind of kinetic energy.
Oh, yeah.
And those can be a lot of fun as a family. And so finding a couple of games that your family likes, that can be some of the dance games are this way. But there's a lot of other ones that are constantly coming out. It's one of the great things about some of the modern video game consoles that really do a lot more sort of action. So that could be another thing that you invest in during the winter to burn off some of that energy.
Yes. Another one is inside playhouse or, like, trampoline park. So we actually have one here on Maui. If you ever come to Maui, Ultimate Air, we love Ultimate Air. John, if you're watching, you're the man. A good friend, own and operate and run that thing. And it's just, like, the cleanest, the nicest, the best one. And our kids absolutely love it. I mean, I love it, right? It's one of those ones where I kind of want to go because I want to jump and I want to absolutely blow up 10-year-olds in the dodgeball, you know, arena. And it's so fun. But yeah, that's a really, really good one. And I think there's nothing better. I don't know many places in, like, the warehouses or, like, kind of trampoline parks that are, like, the best psychologically for just, like, containment of toddlers, where you can visually see them, but you kind of know they're in a building. That alone is worth it. Like, when I really need peace of mind or just want to just be like, let them kind of go without having to micromanage them or make sure they don't die, that's a great place.
Yeah, I would say another one, you guys, is wrestling with your kids. There's so much evidence that this is really, really helpful for bonding. It's not just for energy. There's a lot of, so if you're resistant to this, or, you know, you haven't really thought about this, I'd encourage you guys, especially in the winter, maybe set up a room in your house, like, pad it a little bit more and make it a fun thing for you and your kids, just kind of wrestle around on the floor and really enjoy that time. And to make it a time is really kind of a cool idea, especially, like, again, in the winter, trying to burn energy. Don't get them all riled up right before you put them to bed. This is something that's kind of good to do a couple hours before bedtime, but really try to get out that energy and really enjoy that sort of rough and tumble play that is so healthy between dads and their kids.
Yep. And then the last one is, and Jeremy's actually seen this one firsthand, is scooter track, which we have a fun little home where our downstairs can go in a circle, meaning, like, you can just keep literally going and it's, like, a setup perfectly for a track. And so, and by the way, I'm totally of the belief, and I think dads take this on too, of, like, I want our home to be a place of joy, of fun, of being a blast, almost to be a little theme park. And so I want to push the envelope with how far can we go of bringing, like, fun, rebellious, quote unquote, things that people say don't do in the home, like throwing balls or riding your skateboard or riding your scooter, and do them in the home while, of course, respecting the home, making sure stuff doesn't break. And so we push that and we test it rather than, like, no to everything. We say, hey, can we get scooters that have, like, non-marking wheels that don't put any things? And we found those. And so then, like, they do that and it's fun and doesn't leave any marks. We tried, you know, like, can we play catch or can you throw football in the house? At some level we did, but then they started to break some things too much. So we said, hey, maybe let's wait till you're a little older, because I was trying to explain, like, hey, you can only throw it this high, but like my kids don't have that accuracy at age five. but I think that's a fun philosophy, by the way, to change the philosophy of like basically no playing inside, because we say no. I don't think parents realize how many times they say no to just like, don't do that, don't do that, yeah. don't do that, don't do that. And so I think like actually kind of take the opposite of how far can we push bringing fun, playful things into the home while obviously being like sustainable to the home and not just making, you know, you're destroying everything. And we've tried to find that so that then there is kind of controlled things that seem like, oh my goodness, I can't believe I can scooter in the home. But when you like do it, that doesn't do anything to the home. It doesn't break anything. It doesn't mess anything up. So it's really kind of fun. So those are five ways to help your kids burn energy in the winter.
And you guys, it's really important to be creative as a dad to get a lot of these kinds of ideas going. Sometimes we get stuck. And so that's why we wrote and published 31 creative ways to build your family team. So just like Jeff and I just went over five different creative ways to really help you guys get through these winter months. This book, it's also a video course, is really helpful for understanding what are some of those creative ways really to get your mind working creatively for how to build your family. So you can get 31 creative ways to build your family team on Amazon at familyteams.com. So check that out.